How do you know that the Quran is the word of God? How do you know that Bible is
the word of God? Well,
we can get to that. I will answer, but I asked the question first. So could you explain to me, and I'm open with ears, how do you know the Quran is the word of God?
Just the same answer as I told you before.
So you don't know?
No, I know.
You don't know?
I know.
How do you know?
You know the Quran well, yeah?
Well, I don't.
You know that surah there? Surah 29-27, you know that surah?
I know by heart a lot.
You know, do you understand what it says? It says, "He bestowed upon him Isaac and Jacob and caused them to have revelation to you
and his offspring."
Okay? Now, in the Quran, it's saying that revelation and prophethood comes through the line of Isaac and Jacob. Now, Muhammad is a descendant of Ishmael, correct? So, if Muhammad is a descendant of Ishmael, at the same time, he cannot be a descendant of Isaac and Jacob. And the Quran says that revelation and scripture comes through the line of Isaac and Jacob. So my question is, how can Muhammad be a prophet when the Quran rules him out as a true prophet,
according to that surah? You brought it in. So without this, it doesn't say that it will not bring any prophethood through Ishmael.
Exactly.
It does not say that.
I know. That's what I'm asking. Why?
No, I'm saying it does not say that. It will not bring.
It says Isaac and Jacob.
Yeah, it will send the offspring.
Where's Ishmael?
Because Quran is not made of one verse. It has more than 6,000 verses.
Yes.
So it will bring one verse out of context.
Okay.
Yeah. It doesn't mean whole Quran.
Okay.
Yeah. The whole Quran of several places is saying Prophet Muhammad is the messenger of God.
Yeah.
You brought one verse from Quran. Yeah. It says Prophet Muhammad is the messenger of God in many places.
Oh, yes, I know that. Yeah, exactly. That, yeah.
So you took out one verse out of context from nowhere.
If Ishmael is a prophet, is claimed, and he's the older brother, he should be mentioned right there in that passage. You should say Ishmael because he's the older brother, and Isaac's the younger brother.
So do you know how many prophets are mentioned in the Quran?
Very many, I believe.
How many?
Well, you mentioned Jesus, you mentioned all of them, more or less all of them.
How many of them are mentioned?
I don't know in total, but there's a lot of them.
So all the prophets are mentioned here?
This verse is saying that the prophetic office is coming through the line of Israel, nothing to do with Arabia. Now, we do know Muhammad. You say Muhammad is a descendant of Ishmael. We do realize Muhammad was born, there's no Ishmaelites. They had gone. So we cannot be a descendant of a race that has vanished from the face of the earth. And history proves that.
So are you from Christian?
I'm Christian, yes.
You believe in God, right?
I believe in God, yes.
So let's talk about the foundation. Rather than going to the every bits and pieces, taking verse out of context.
Well, that's why I'm asking, can you bring context?
Well, so let's establish the concept of God first, yeah? So how many gods do you believe in?
I believe in one God.
Who is God?
Let's stick to this, though.
No.